Yeah.
Life will never be the same, and there will never be a change. There's something in the sky we all try to describe, but there'll never be a name. I ain't talking about a shower from above when I tell you I'm prepared for the rain. So metaphorically speaking, this will be around forever, cause there'll never be a drain. My flood for a flow will remain, even when I lose everything that I've gained. If God is the music and the devil is the fame, I'm a rebel in the making, cause I'm leveling the plane. Trying to unlock from the pressure and the pain, with the devil getting clever with the chains. I knew what I was before I entered in the game, I'm just trying to understand what I became.
See, I was told.
Hi guys, my name's Ethan. I've been just a bit slack on getting a vlog up or a blog or whatever you want to call it. I tried doing it, but this is what happened. My cords all caught fire when I was trying to use this guy, and stuff got jammed in it, and I'm pretty sure I need a new one now. So I'm on the laptop. I've been training a fair bit. I've put on a fair bit of weight. I looked on the scales the other day, I got a bit of a shock. I'm at 80 kilos now. 80 kilos is a big deal for me. I wasn't this big last time. I think I was living at home. I had the home cooking for my mum. I love my mum. She's an Italian woman. She used to feed me quite well. I miss those days. I've been throwing some extra meals in there. I've been trying to eat quite large meals. I've seen another couple of things there to eat a lot of small meals if you're struggling to eat large meals. I've been doing that too. If I'm eating small meals throughout the day, which is like days I have work and stuff like that, I try and make sure I get around 8. If I can get to 10, it's even better. I mean, the more you eat, the better it is. I've been eating a lot of minces, a lot of meats, a lot of chicken, a lot of fish. I go spearfishing a fair bit. It's been good for me, keeping the joints good. So my training's going okay. I mean, I'm coming back from injury. At the end of last year, we're really close to the end of it, I broke a part of my knee. And it slices up what's called the meniscus. You guys would probably know that if you know the human body. The joint's all sliced up, and sometimes it tries to pop the actual joint out when it gets in the wrong spot. Still waiting on surgery for that, so I'm trying to save up my money to get it.
Check it out, yeah, it's that moment when you're lost in the feeling. You own it, you're on top of the building. You front row, it's your favorite show. You love it loud and you wanna let your neighbors know that right now we run the town. It's our chance to dance like no one's around. Love like this, can't buy it with a buck. Better dig hard for your diamond in the rough. Like me, my girl in a timeless classic. At peace with the world when the vibe is magic. Close your eyes, vision the scene, and for a single moment you'll be living the dream. And even though it might take a while, when your song comes on, bet it makes you smile. Laughing like Martin, run and tell that shit. Fact is, right now nothing else matters. Madness.
Restricting me a little bit with leg movement and stuff like that, so I've been focusing more on upper body. I've been trying rehab and stuff to make sure my legs get better. I'm up to the stage now after doing a bit of yoga and stuff like that, and rehab where I can actually jog. I can dance, obviously. Been able to walk for a fair while and do all that normal stuff, but the being able to jog and actually about to start using weights is pretty good. It's a slow process. I mean, I can't rush it. I'm pretty eager to do that. My personality, I've noticed my personality has changed quite a bit. It's pretty good when your family members, people you haven't told that you're doing this competition, they come up to you, they tell you you look really healthy, you know, you get the old squeeze in the arm, or, your girlfriend or something, like whatever you guys have, if you have a boyfriend or whatever it is. She comes up and you know, checks you out a fair bit more and stuff like that. And, you know, she's pretty supportive now and stuff. Only thing is, my moods have been, I've been a bit more cranky. When I don't get my food, I'm a bit, a bit nappy until someone gives me some. Usually my girlfriend will try and do that whenever she thinks I'm a little bit too, you know, pissed off. She'll just feed me a sandwich or something like that. I mean, it's pretty good. I've been taking my supplements. I've been taking Max's Supersize, the big red box, 10 kilograms of that. Pretty large servings, to be honest, just for their normal servings, I thought. It's really thick shakes, you know. I've been taking that with some other types of supplements, such as BCAAs. I've been taking some creatine, trying to put on that extra water weight. I've been taking some tribulus on the really bad days where, you know, you're really, really sore and you can't be bothered training, hoping that, you know, that extra kick of testosterone might make it, you know, a bit easier for me to get out there. I stopped taking pre-workouts. I read on the back of them, if you read up on it and all the things that I have in them, some of the stuff is a bit scary. I know the Max one, apparently, I went on the forum and they said it's pretty safe for you. But just watch out if you're using other supplements and stuff. I've seen some on there about cancer-causing stuff. I've seen some other stuff that says that it's banned, you're not allowed to use it. Some things have been discontinued for those reasons. So make sure you know what you're taking so, you know, you're not damaging your body in the long term. So, yeah. You know, I think this is a really good idea for little guys trying to get big. I mean, you always see, like, Biggest Loser, bigger guys trying to get small and, you know, It's a double standard too. Like you actually start to think when you're really skinny that you lose a lot of self-esteem. Like you notice the skinny guy. There's been times you've been walking down the street or something like that with some chick you might like, and she'll be checking out this other dude saying, "Oh, look at his muscles" or something like that, and you're just sitting there thinking, "What? Like, you know, I'm here," kind of thing. You know, that stuff happens, and you kind of get used to it. In sports, it was good because I was quicker than the other guys who were a lot bigger than me. But when they actually caught up to me, it hurt a lot. Playing footy and stuff like that. So, you know, trying to get big and stuff like that, it just gives you confidence. You know, I know that some guys get big and they think they're the big macho guy and all that kind of stuff, but I'm getting a lot more confidence in my dancing. I can do moves that I couldn't do before. I can always show off a little bit. I'm not the best. I'm not even near elite level yet with my breakdancing, but you know, I can do moves now that the guys I look up to that I train with and stuff like that, they actually look at it and think, you know, wow, this kid's got a lot of strength and stuff going on for him. Been trying to work on doing no-footed push-ups, like in a push-up position. I'm almost there. I've been working quite hard at trying to do it. I might give you a clip of that later on if I finally get it in these vlogs. I've been working hard at that. I've been working hard at a lot of power stuff too. I know strength training is meant to be, you know, a certain amount of reps, trying to aim for about 8 to 12, you know, and trying to get past that point. And power's like 6 to 8, somewhere around that mark when you're maxing out. So, you know, I kind of mix it up a bit. I've also been doing a lot of aerobic stuff. You know, I might work all day doing dance teaching, and so if I'm doing that, you know, I need to eat, and sometimes I don't have time to, and that's a bad thing. It's putting me back a little bit sometimes, and my weight's going a bit all over the place. But I've noticed since I started doing that, I'm still sort of seeing the definition and the size. I don't know if you're meant to try and just get big, including with size as well, without the definition, and then lose it all at the end, or if you're meant to do both at the same sort of time. So if I could get some feedback on that, I'd be good. But yeah, so that's my blog for now. I'm going to quickly just chuck in the fundamental things, show you guys some stuff I've been working on and some supplements I've been using. And yeah, hopefully you'll see a bit more of me on here. I'll try not to be as slack as I have been. Alright, see you guys, see you, Max Up Challenge people, bye.